video full title of CHO, Chief Happiness Officer at Inspire to Aspire Consulting. With over 30 years of business experience, Mahesh describes his mission in life as to spread health and happiness throughout the world. He uses a holistic approach to empower people to achieve their personal, professional wellness goals and be healthy, happy, vibrant, positive, energized, and engaged. This ties in closely with one of the mission-led themes of community business, which focuses on ensuring happy, healthy, and engaged employees. Mahesh will share how positive rituals can make a powerful impact both on yourself and those around you, bringing benefits to the workplace and beyond. So over to you, Mahesh.
Hi, everyone. The topic is harnessing personal power to impact positive change. What is positive change? Now, each one knows what is positive change. Somebody wants to lose weight, positive change. Somebody wants to make more money, positive change. Somebody wants to help the community, positive change. Right? Anything that you do that helps you live well is positive, right? How do you do it? Does it happen by thinking? No. You have to take action, right? So that personal power is taking action. Now, this is how it works. It starts with, I don't know, there's fear, hesitation, you know, you don't know what is possible and what is not. And then slowly, out of that hopelessness, the fear, what comes out is, maybe I can do it. Then you get skills, the confidence, and then finally you're like, yes, I made it. Like, you know, so that's positive change up there. But you need to go up the ladder to get to that change, right? So, like for me, that is a mission in my life, to show people how to do this, how to get to that, right? So, let me introduce myself. My name is Mahesh. So, I'm 52 years old, married since 27 years. I've been living in Hong Kong. My wife is here with me today. My wife's name is Honey. My name in the community is Happy. I have a daughter whose name is Joy. And here's another thing. My ID card, I have a Hong Kong ID card. My Chinese name is Pang Ma He, which means happy horse. So, and you know what's my business title? Chief Happiness Officer. Now here's the most corny bit. I am so happy to be in front of all of you. Anyway, this happiness is new for me. I used to not be happy. So I'll show you something. So this is me in 2007. You can't see my belly, right? Like, I used to be size 38. I used to work. Travel, make money, be very successful. But I should not be happy. So what do I do? What's my other business? So I sell media to TV stations all over the world. In fact, there's a joke that I used to say, you know. Anybody used to ask me, what do you do? Say, I'm the Li Ka Shing of the media business. Anybody knows Li Ka Shing? Does everybody know who he is? He's the richest guy in Hong Kong. You know, you make a phone call, he makes money. You drink water, he makes money. You buy cosmetics, he makes money. He makes money everywhere, okay? Now, you know how I make money? I sell the recording media to the TV stations. And you guys watch TV? You turn on the TV, I make money. Yeah, everybody watches TV, right? Yeah, so I make money because of that. So, very successful, but not happy. That was the thing. I used to follow this model, which was, if I'm successful, if I buy my apartment, if I buy my office, if I buy my warehouse, I get everything, then I'll be happy. And unfortunately, that didn't work out. I used to just have stress and no good health. So I had a sinus problem back then when I was 86 kilos. Today I'm 74 kilos, fit, right? And my waistline is 32. So the thing is, that model didn't work for me. So anyway, I went to a Nature Cure clinic in India. It's called Jindal Nature Cure. And every day, I used to do yoga, I used to do breathing exercises, and all kinds of healthy food, you know. You saw what they posted, right? What are you supposed to do in those six things? Eat a healthy meal, laugh. So one of the things that we do in Jindal every morning for 20 minutes is we used to do laughter yoga. So you laugh for no reason. Right? Anybody has tried it? Has anybody tried laughter yoga? Okay, good, let's try it then. So, turn to the person next to you. Everybody put down your phones. and shake your hands and laugh, okay? Shake your hands and laugh. So, basically that is laughter yoga, right? You laugh for no reason. But you know what? It makes you happy. Laughter makes you happy. You know, that's one of the things that they tell you, right? Smile at somebody. Someone that you don't know. Or laugh. So these are things that make... Now, I was like, I learned laughter yoga there. And then I came to Hong Kong, I'm like, there's not many people doing this. Let's start a movement. So we started the laughter yoga club. So what we used to do, go to the park and laugh. And people used to be like, are you crazy? Like, yeah, join us. So we used to just laugh for no reason. And the thing grew, right? After a while, the Hong Kong police found out about us. They're like, our staff, they're so depressed, they're so stressed out, please come and make them laugh. The banks, the insurance companies, like, everybody's like, we need this in our company. So we actually set up a company. Here's the thing. I really, really enjoy more doing this pro bono work. I used to do it free of charge, but I used to feel more happier then doing that than making $1 million in my business. Because it was fulfilling, right? It was fulfilling. I'm like, okay, laughter yoga is one thing. Can we do something else? So I actually studied positive psychology in the Holbein Institute in the US. So this is the Holbein Institute. And what is positive psychology? Anybody knows? It's basically a science. The science of happiness. So what is a science? A science is if person A does something and person B does something, if they get the same result, that's a science. So in positive psychology, what do? Is you look at the happy people in life, what are they doing? And you copy them. Because they got happy by doing something. So why not do it yourself? So I studied positive psychology at a whole, like, very deep level. And so the model was no longer success equal to happiness, but the model changed, it reversed. The model now became, if I am happy, I will be successful. So, how do you become happy, which leads to success, which leads to peak performance, which leads to taking on, you know, different activities that empower you? Right? So this is a model that we use in positive psychology of the Holbein Institute. So it's called the SPIRE model. So happiness equal to well-being, but well-being in all five areas. So spiritual well-being, physical well-being, intellectual well-being, relational well-being, and emotional well-being. So let me explain what is each segment, because That is how you create rituals in around that area. So spiritual well-being is what I see in community business, for example. I see it in what Impact Hong Kong is doing. They do what they feel is meaningful and purpose, you know, it has a purpose in life. It's not like, I go to the office, I make money. And then what? Right? What's next after you make money, then what? Because here's what, you make money, you will not be happy. It's guaranteed. You know, it's guaranteed. You know why I say this? In March, if you read the South China Morning Post, there was an article. How many millionaires in Hong Kong? 770,000. How many multi-millionaires in Hong Kong? There's, you know, that's people over the, whoever. And this is besides their property value. Okay? This is cash and stocks that they hold in their hand. How many multi-millionaires? Value over 10 million. 70,000. Guess what? They are not happy. So you want to get this. You go after money, at the end of the day, you're not going to be happy. What's the point? Rather do something that makes you happier. So for me, it started with laughter yoga, and then it became spreading positive psychology. So positive psychology first looks for a meaning and purpose. So my meaning and purpose in life, be healthy and happy. Inspire others to be healthy and happy and to aspire for higher goals in life. Don't just go to a job and 9 to 5, you know. You want to progress. So how do you do that? You do that by learning, by training yourself. So there's physical well-being, learning how to manage your body, making sure that you get the right food, you get the sleep, you do the exercises, you get water into your system. Because that's how you get healthy physically. Intellectual learning is learning. You know, it's a very important thing. You want to be successful in life, you have to learn. Who are the world's best investors? Take, for example, Warren Buffett. Why is he so successful? Ever asked? So he was asked this question. He says, because I read balance sheets. He doesn't sit and watch Bloomberg all day. He's reading balance sheets. He knows how much is the cash flow, how the business is going to grow. Today, nowadays, what do people read? Facebook. People are on Twitter. Like, hello. Okay, social media is important, but you want to do some deep work in life, you have to have some learning behind it, which comes from reading, deep reading. Okay? Then there's relational. So relational well-being is you have to be willing to work together with others so that they can contribute to you and you can contribute to them. That's relational well-being. And then emotional well-being. Now, here's a fact of life. In life, you'll go like this, everything is happy, 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 and then suddenly, you crash. Now, when you are coming down, how do you go back up quickly? So what you need in that is resilience. So resilience is, you know that this is a cycle. It's going to go up, it's going to go down, again it's going to come back up. But you have to manage that cycle. So generating enough positive emotions. See, one of the exercises that they keep telling you to do, be grateful. What are you grateful for? Do you know how great that is? Do you have any idea what's the science behind it? So here's what they did. They took people who had won a lottery. You know what happens to people who won a lottery? Their happiness goes, yay, goes up. And then 6 months later, their happiness is back to the same level that it was before they won the lottery. On the other hand, they took people who were actually writing a gratitude journal three times a day, three times, you know, just before bed, a few minutes, I'm grateful for ABC. The happiness of those people went up by like 70% after 1 year. So winning a lottery doesn't make you happy. Being grateful makes you more happier. So these are things that I learned in this model that I like to teach to the world. I want this work to be in schools, because what are we learning? Just, you know, the maths, the science. Sometimes it's not as important as this, because you know what this does? It gives you this. It gives you a balanced whole person well-being. What is a balanced whole person well-being? Your family. You know, there's a study. If you have good relationships with your family, you will earn more, you will live more, you will be happier. This is a study done. This was a 70-year study done by Howard University. So, I mean, I did a course once in Hong Kong. 66% of the participants in the course were either divorced or had no marriage. Like, that's terrible. Like, how can you avoid family? You know, you need to have, if you want to be successful in life, you need to have good relationship with your family. The other thing is social currency. You need friends, not friends on Facebook. You need real friends who you can talk to one-on-one. Because in hard times, they are the ones who come through. They are the ones like, okay, you can come out of it, you can come out of it. So we have to develop that, not keep adding friends. We have to remove our Facebook friends because they just show off. There's no meaning there, you know. So that's friendship. The other thing is goals. Like, when you work on something, do it with meaning and purpose. Like, it's not, I'll just do my job. No. It's like, how can I take it to the next level? If I'm an accountant, I want to be the best accountant. If I'm a trainer, I want to be the best trainer. If I'm doing anything, I want to be number one. Like, so that when you do that, you are happier, right? The other thing is, follow your passion. So for me, I love this, right? Talking to people, empowering them to do something with their life. I love that. So follow that. I mean, you could be having something else. For him, like, it's supporting the poor. It's a fantastic cause. So do what empowers you, right? That's very important. The other thing is exercise. How many of you exercise every day? Few, like 20%. You know one of the stats in Hong Kong? 66% of Hong Kong women don't exercise. About 50-some percent of males don't exercise. This is from the Institute of Hong Kong Education. Okay? So, do you know what exercise does? You go to exercise, there's these chemicals that explode in your brain that make you more energized, more happy. You want peak performance? Go for a jog. Do your yoga. Do your breathing exercises. These are the things that make a difference in your life. Because here's what people are doing. They wake up in the morning. First of all, their phone is right next to them. Facebook or WeChat or WhatsApp. Like, it's become an epidemic, right? It doesn't help you. Rather, you go for a run or do something to get, you know, what are the chemicals? You have dopamine, like serotonin. These are chemicals that come out that make you happy, healthy, focused in your work. And they suppress, the exercise that suppresses cortisol, which is the stress hormone. You know, what is the diabetes rate in Hong Kong? It's about 11%. 20 years back, it was 1%. People used to work with their hands. Walk. Now everything is, take it easy. So we have to realize that motion creates emotion. You have to learn to move, and exercise is one of the best ways to move. The other thing is meditation. Like, it's so helpful. I mean, I cannot emphasize more. I know it helps me. I do it every day. It helps me. So I can share more, but I'm going to go on. The other thing is sleep. How many of you sleep at least 8 hours a day?
At least.
Not bad. That's pretty good. I can see a few hands up. Most people in Hong Kong, they don't get to sleep. 42% of Hong Kong women, specifically women, they don't get to sleep at night. They're sleeping like 3-4 hours a day. Why? What are they doing? Again, Facebook, WeChat, whatever. They're playing video games. And then next morning, you can see them in the MTR, right? People are so disengaged. So the thing is, how can you do quality work if you are not rested? Rest and recovery is part of what you learn in positive psychology. Next, volunteering. I'm telling you, you want to succeed in life? Give to others. Help others. Share your wisdom, your money, your resources with others, because you will get back. Volunteering is the best form of giving, right? Next, so now, this is the model that I use. Like, I want to share this, and I want people to be empowered by this and try to use it in their lives. This is my schedule, daily schedule. I do this more or less every single day. Wake up in the morning, either go for a jog for 45 minutes, I do about between 6.5K to 8.5K. So every day, I come back, I get my 7 hours sleep, I'll get ready, I'll do my gratitude practice. So gratitude practice, what I do is I drink a glass of water, and while I'm drinking water, I say thank you to all my teachers, all my family members, all my staff, my clients, my suppliers, my brain, my nervous system, my circulatory system. Everything gets a thank you. Now here's what, our brain needs positive emotions. How do you get positive emotions? By being grateful. If you be grateful, you're happier, you're more focused in your work. So I get ready, do my gratitude, I do either exercise, so I go either for the run or I do my yoga every day without fail. Now, yoga includes breathing exercises. Most Hong Kong people don't know how to breathe. You know how they breathe? That's not breathing. You know, the lungs, the 6 liters capacity, people are getting like 100 ml into their lungs. Like, you have to learn how to breathe, because if you know how to breathe, you will be so active. You will have peak performance. I'm telling you, because I run 2 businesses. I'm still number 1 in Asia Pacific in my media business, and I do my workshops, and I handle my investments. How am I able to do it? Because I do my exercises every day. So breathing is very important. Take a shower, have breakfast. Now, how many of you have meals that exceed 20 minutes, 30 minutes? Normally, how come? Eat it fast, eat it fast. Let's go to something else. It doesn't help. You're not eating. There are no teeth in the intestine. The teeth are up here. So if you keep just swallowing it, the food is not digested. No energy. And then people are like, so the thing is, I actually sit down. I don't stand up and eat. Sit down. Slow down. One of the activities is slow down. Okay, next. I get to the office. First thing, turn off Wi-Fi, turn off mobile data. Because what happens? Ding, somebody's sending me a photo. Ding, somebody's sending. Like, do I need to see that? It's not productive. Right? So the thing is, you want to get this. You start doing this, and you'll see the productive work that you get done by this. I go home every day, I take a nap after my lunch. Every day without fail. I've been doing it for the last 20 years, by the way. 10 minutes, I come back, I'm fully refreshed. So, you can take a nap, right, in the office, or you can't. My staff do that, I allow them to do that. I even have a sofa in my office, go, sleep. But, so the thing is, it helps. These are the things that bring out energy. So you want to be physically energized, you want to be emotionally connected, you want to be mentally focused and spiritually aligned. Those are the things. You need to get more energy into you. Again, work in the afternoon, in the evening, I go shopping with my wife. My wife says, let's go market shop. Mother. Okay, let's go. It's a walk also. I'm with my wife. Why not? Have dinner. Then I watch some TV. I do watch some TV, not the amount that most people watch. And then I do my meditation every day. Without fail. And after that, my daughter will come, Daddy, family time! And she just sit and chat, how was her day, what did she do? So it builds bonds, right? You do that. So it's a whole thing. Now, how do you integrate this into your life is by adding 30-day challenges into your life. My time is running out, but some of the ways is, do an activity for only 2 to 5 minutes, but do it consistently every day for 30 days. It becomes a habit. That's a positive ritual. You do it every day without fail. You run or you drink water, you write a journal. Journaling is fantastic activity for the brain. through meditation, or yeah, just do breathing exercises. You know, I teach this in my workshops. I love this work because it empowers people. And also do yoga. So start. Right? Look, here's the thing. Nobody can make you do it. You have to do it yourself. That you have to take that personal power that is with you and take action. You take action, you will get results. It's your action. Nobody can push you. Thank you and good luck.